This video is brought to you in part by Patreon producers Cameron D, John Belf, and Ralph Nunez. If you'd also like to become a producer, head over to patreon.com/616Entertainment for more information. You won't regret it.
The following video features my own personal opinion. This is my list ranking the Mortal Kombat games in order of worst to best. This list will differ from yours, as we are not the same human being. I would be more than happy to check out your list in the comments. If we keep it civil, we have a hell of a topic of conversation on our hands here. Enjoy the video.
Mortal Kombat. God damn, what a franchise. What all began in 1992 just saw its most recent release, Mortal Kombat 11, drop in April of 2019. We've come a long way from the days of dimly lit arcades, that's for sure. For the complete story of Mortal Kombat, check out my 2018 documentary that covers the entire series from inception to current day. In today's video, I'll be ranking the 14 mainline entries in the Mortal Kombat franchise. That's MK1 to MK11, plus the three spin-off titles. Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, Mortal Kombat Trilogy, MK Gold. I consider all of these add-ons, compilations, or ports, so I won't be including them. Feel free to share your list in the comments. I'd love to compare and contrast our choices. My name is Ian, you're watching 616 Entertainment, and I'm about to rank the Mortal Kombat games at your request, as this was indeed a subscriber milestone video. Let's get to it. We're going to open this list with the most obvious last place decision of all time, Mortal Kombat Special Forces. This 2000 PlayStation exclusive drops into the number 14 slot for obvious reasons. The gameplay sucks. The graphics suck. The story sucks. If you called this one Covert Ops Special Forces and removed any logos or names tying it to MK, no one would have any idea it was supposed to be tied to Mortal Kombat at all. Special Forces isn't a horrible game in the way that The Room is a horrible movie, where it's still fun to watch specifically because of how bad it is. It's just boring. It's nothing. It's a chore. Who saw this coming? I swear, the list will become less predictable. Just stay with me. Mortal Kombat Mythology's Sub-Zero isn't nearly as bad as Special Forces. It's unfairly difficult, sure. Extremely poorly designed, 100%. Not gripping at all in a way that makes the player want to try and overcome whatever odds are in their way. Not at all. The worst part about Mythologies is that the concept is awesome. Playing as a single character in the MK universe and uncovering secrets about their past is a compelling idea to this day. But god damn, did this one miss the mark. Mythologies is a game I wouldn't recommend you go out of your way to play. It's just not worth it. There are fans of this title who got very upset at me over burying it in my History of Mortal Kombat documentary, and that's fine. You can like whatever you want, I won't tell you not to, but I will not be admitting anytime soon that this game is any good, because it's not. Listen, I love Freddy vs. Jason. Is it a good movie? Hell no. The acting is terrible.
Come on, get real. You're not even scary.
The characters explain to the audience what is happening in literally every scene.
Are you crazy? You got what you wanted. You pulled Freddy out. Now he's fighting Jason. Come on. What more do you want?
He killed my mother, Will. It was Freddy. My dad covered it up to protect me. He didn't do it.
But the violence is 10 out of 10. The action scenes are completely insane. And overall, the movie appeals to the child in me who always wanted to see these two fight. See? We all like things that are terrible sometimes. Let's be honest. Mortal Kombat 3 is awesome. It's not low on my list because the game is bad, so get that out of your head and drop your pitchforks. Remember what I said about this list being my list that represents my opinions alone. MK3 is low on my list for a few reasons. First off, the roster. Come on. We're missing out on some of our top tier favorites, you can't deny that. If we were talking about Ultimate MK3 or Trilogy, it's a different story, but we're not. We're focusing on the original Mortal Kombat 3. Secondly, I just never got that good at this game. This is entirely on me, and I take the blame. That's my fault. You need to remember that I was still 5 years old when MK3 first dropped, and the combo system was just outside of my skill set at the time. I was little, I felt overwhelmed, and I always found more comfort in MK1 and 2. Don't get me wrong, I still played the shit out of 3. I just didn't build a huge connection with it. Before we move on, though, let's make something clear. If we're ranking soundtracks, MK3 would be up there, Dan Dans. Many of you will find this one hard to believe, but I enjoy Mortal Kombat 4 more than MK3. The combat was less intense as far as the skill needed to be successful is concerned. I was intrigued by the new faces, the graphical style, the switch to three dimensions. I really loved the soundtrack. MK4 just clicked with me, guys. There are many who say that these graphics are bad today and were bad even in 1997 when this game first released, but I've never felt that way. They're not gorgeous or anything, but this came out the same year as Gauntlet Legends. Is one really way better looking than the other? Either way, yeah, I like MK4. Not enough to rank it higher than number 11, though.
This is a fatality.
Things are getting crazy now, right? Deadly Alliance is an awesome game, guys. It introduced the Crypt, which is still around to this day. It marked the debut for low-key favorites like Natara, Kenshi, and Li Mei. This was the first MK game that allowed players to switch between different fighting styles. But the fatality design is largely lackluster. Conquest mode is a glorified tutorial. Deadly Alliance brings a lot to the table, but as we'll see later in the list, its sequels took the features that made the game special and vastly improved on them. Here's the perfect opportunity to explain what I was just talking about. Mortal Kombat Deception earns the number 9 spot over Deadly Alliance because the fatalities are better, the roster is bigger, we've got cool-ass minigames, more stages with more stage fatalities, and holy hell is Conquest mode out of control. Did you know you wanted an open-world RPG of sorts in a Mortal Kombat game? I didn't either. Not until Deception dropped in my lap and I played the entire story with a smile plastered on my face like I got hit with the Joker's toxin. The PS2 era of Mortal Kombat, as I like to call it, just seemed to get better and better with each installment. Some of you just shit your pants over me placing MK vs. DC Universe above Deception, but guys, it's okay. Hear me out on this one. First of all, I love shit that's a little crazy. Why did this game even happen? Because someone thought it was a surefire way to make money? Probably. But still, who saw this coming? It's insane. It's a direct fuck you to Marvel vs. Capcom, which is hilarious. No disrespect to MVC at all, not one bit. It's just funny. It's like WWE having the 30-man Royal Rumble, and WCW saying, well, we have a 60-man Rumble with three rings! It's superbly stupid. Also, I'm a DC guy. I love DC Comics. You know I'm a huge Superman fan, but I love Batman just as much. Green Lantern and The Flash have always been intriguing to me. Joker is always awesome. Including Shazam was something I never thought would happen. We've got an excellent cheeseball story mode, and let's give credit where credit is due. MK vs. DC set the stage for what Mortal Kombat is doing with its cinematic story modes to this day. Were the neutered fatalities extremely lame? Yeah, for the most part. But I don't care, man. I love MK vs. DC. A strong number 8 for me. They say less is more. I mean, sometimes they're right. But in Mortal Kombat Armageddon, they're way off. Armageddon ranks in at number 7 because despite its faults, namely the dog shit creative fatality system, there's a ton of fun to be had here. Create a fighter? Dope. Conquest mode? Dope. Access to every fighter in MK history?
For the most part.
Dope. There are an ass load of stages, a ridiculous amount of death traps and hazards, and a fucking kart racer to boot. MK Armageddon is great. Don't let anyone tell you differently. This is where it's really starting to get difficult for me, Dan Dance. Mortal Kombat X, for example, is an excellent entry in the franchise, but if I had MKX along with the 5 other games I haven't slotted yet, I'm pretty sure I'd prefer to play any of them over this one. That's not an insult, it's just, we're about to break the top 5, you know what I mean? MKX has a fun story mode, it introduced some cool new faces, the fatalities were off the charts impressive. But I can't drop it in the top 5. MKX, I love ya. But we gotta get into the top 5. I love MK1, guys. Can you tell? We're kicking off the top 5, the big boys, with the game that started it all. Is the 1992 original the game that has by far the least going for it in the features department? Why, yes. Is it the game with the smallest roster? By far. Am I ranking it this high based mostly on nostalgia? 100%. But listen, my friends, nostalgia is super powerful. The nostalgia of MK1 puts a much bigger smile on my face than being able to switch between three fighting styles like in Deadly Alliance, or playing in 1080p on Mortal Kombat X. The original Mortal Kombat triggers vivid memories, man, and you're goddamn right it's top 5 worthy for that reason alone. I know what you're thinking. Oh, you only put Mortal Kombat 11 at number 4 because it's new and you're still in love with it. Nope. Wrong. MK11 cracks the top 4 for me because I love the way this game feels. The gameplay fits perfectly into my gaming habits, like a glove. I absolutely adore the roster, new faces and grizzled veterans alike. Most MK games have me playing as one character over and over because they're the one I really click with, but that's not the case with 11. Noob Saibot, Cetrion, Sub-Zero, Baraka, Liu Kang, we're just getting started. I can flip between a handful of fighters and feel right at home. The fatalities are out of this world, and the design of the crypt is Mortal Kombat Disneyland. Customizing fighters, while a little strict, is really cool. There's no nostalgia in this placement on the list. The game is still brand new. This pick I base solely on the fact that I can tell, years from now, I'm going to be pulling MK11 off my shelf and having a great time. What is there to say about Mortal Kombat 2 that hasn't already been said? When I think Mortal Kombat, I immediately think of the first two games. MK1 set the tone and MK2 flipped it on its fucking head. The stages were darker and scarier, the fatalities were more violent, the roster had been expanded, and we were introduced to one of the all-time greats in video game boss history, Shao Kahn. Seriously, fuck Shao Kahn. If you've ever played MK2, you know exactly why I felt the need to say that. Beating this big asshole filled players with the sense of accomplishment that could rival any other victory you've ever experienced. MK2 is amazing, and I'll never not love this one to death. I don't know if there's a video game in the world that made me mark out as often as Mortal Kombat 9. Every single cutscene in the story mode had a little something in it that had MK diehards pointing and screaming at the TV. Retelling the events of MK1 through 3 allowed us to travel back to those classic environments in HD and see them in a way we never had before. The story itself was incredible, filled with jaw-dropping deaths, mind-bending swerves, and heart-wrenching failures. The gameplay? 10 out of 10. The fatalities? Forget about it. Not putting this in the number one slot was extremely difficult, but sometimes we're forced to make hard decisions. Who the fuck thought a Mortal Kombat spin-off game could be so, so good? Especially after the two colossal letdowns that were Special Forces and Mythologies. Mortal Kombat Shaolin Monks put players in the shoes of Liu Kang and Kung Lao in an action RPG that is just fucking excellent. I can gush about this game for hours, but we're trying to wind this video down, so I'll keep it brief. Before MK9 dazzled us with HD renditions of the pit and the bell tower, Shaolin Monks was letting us freely traverse the Wuxi Academy. We were all over Outworld. We delved deep into the darkness of the living forest. But most importantly of all, we were having fun. Single player or multiplayer, it doesn't matter. Leveling up your fighter and unlocking new moves, abilities, and fatalities is deeply satisfying. And discovering secrets in this world is just next level fun. That's on top of the badass boss fights and truly unique fatalities too. There are very few PS2 games that I go back to as often as Shaolin Monks, and you can bet your ass I'd kill for a remaster of this game running on current gen hardware. And you can bet your balls I'd kill for a sequel on current gen hardware. Both seem unlikely though, but I'll keep on dreaming. And in my dreams, I'm playing Shaolin Monks. That's my list, Dandans. Those are my rankings of the Mortal Kombat games. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget that if you want to share your list in the comments, I will be reading them. I'm always interested in what you guys have to say. If you want to become a patron and support the channel, you can do so at patreon.com/616entertainment. There are some cool perks included for anyone who wants to join. If you don't want to, that's fine too. I love you, and I'll see you next time.